Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to make a heating mantle. Now, hot plate stirrers are great, and for most purposes, you'll never need anything more. But their maximum temperature usually tops out at about 300 to 400 degrees Celsius. If you want to go further, like say for distilling sulfuric acid, you'll need to do better. We're going to make a heating mantle that can reach 700 degrees Celsius. To start, get one of these heating tapes from Mega Engineering. I've included the model number and website in the video description. This tape has power prongs already attached and is insulated for electrical safety. Although don't rely on the insulation completely and assume the tape poses an electrocution hazard when it's powered on. Anyway, let's get started making the mantle. We're going to shape this to fit a 100 milliliter round bottom flask. You can use larger sizes if you like. The procedure is the same. Wind the tape into a roll. Now take the flask and mold the roll against it, creating a cup shape that fits the flask. Tighten the heating tape if you need to ensure the cup is neat and has good contact with the flask. If you're using a larger flask, you'll need to loosen the tape instead. Once you have the shape, use iron wires to hold the shape together. Readjust against the flask if necessary. Now place the assembly in a steel thermos for thermal insulation. Bend over the iron wires as they will support the heating tape. And there you have it, a basic heating mantle. Just assemble the power prongs and this is ready for use. So let's give it a test. Now you could plug this directly into an extension cord leading to an outlet, but there is no power control and the heating mantle will run at full power. This is highly undesirable for sensitive experiments, so I'm going to use a variac autotransformer for power control. You can also use a light dimmer switch or a PID controller if you have one. For our test, I'm just going to go with something simple and boil water. Always set up your apparatus first and plug it in last for safety. Power it up and don't touch it while it's operating. Always power it down and unplug if you need to handle it. Let's give it about 5 minutes. And there we go, boiling water with our amateur heating mantle. Now, of course, boiling water is a trivial use. We're instead going to use this heating mantle in an upcoming video to distill sulfuric acid. So please, subscribe, like, and comment. Thanks for watching! In this video, we're going to purify sulfuric acid by distillation.